10 miles, just on the other side of that, this little rise right here. I'm only about 70 yards away from it. That's general direction. Took it last year up to the top of this canyon. I want to see if I can follow this ridge over a little bit. Non-motorized travel, except if you're a range holder. Not quite too snake scary, so we'll see what happens so far. It's warming up fast into the forecast 70. That was cooler. Just brings down the snakes. There's a good view. There I am right there. This is almost front yard, and so to speak. This canyon does curve that way. I'm going to see what we can do going up that way. Or who knows? Just want to get off this field. I don't like how the trail ends up here. Saddle tank. Doing the snake stomp. That's why snakes don't bother cattle. They feel them coming from a mile away and they flee. Oh, yeah, a little bit. Last time I came out here, it was really wet. Pretty sure it does trail continue to get to the top of that ridge. Warming up a lot more than I thought. Still a nice day. Lovely. Well, I know the trail continues because I did make it up there. But what is the shape of it now? I'd rather have larger trails. Okay. So it's just this kind of maze of smaller ones until it joins the old road, where that might be. That boulder made a little noise when it broke off and rolled down. You know, it's pretty interesting territory on the other side, but I think what we're going to do, what I'm going to do, is try to follow this ridge up to this peak here. Because I've been looking at it for a year and a half from a distance. It'd be kind of nice to stand up there, depending on the snakiness of the ridge. And this is just one small fraction of this foothill area before you even get to the canyons. There's another foreground that is blocking it, but even it, you see that far grass slope there, there's a huge bowl on the other side that could take like 50 homes if you didn't die by living out here. Look at this. I'm sure it's a log, but it looks like a giant bird or something standing there. VGA, who knows. All right, stop yammering. Get to the top of this. Obviously hasn't been an active track for a while. Hey, yucca. Not used to that. It's like a desert. Hey, I remember being up here. I'm sure. Very warm. I'm sweating my balls off at this point. Deer flies. Alright, it's not just one ridge. Okay, that's supposed to go all the way over to Coal Creek. There's a trail. Could take that one. They usually are trails on this on the ridges. Phew, I mean we had a chance of rain here. I might have to wait until it gets a little bit cooler. It's quite warm right now. Doing any climbing. The Badlands clinker rock. Clink. Yeah, this direction you'd sacrifice some elevation. And according to a map I saw, it goes over to Coal Creek, which was the last hike I did. I didn't post it, though. It's got to be on the other side of that ridge. It's got to be at least that far away. That's kind of steep. This trail's possible. It's not one ridge. Got to see how complex it is. It'd be nice if it was a trail. Very, very snaky territory, though. Much warmer than I thought. So I think I'll be doing a stomp no matter where I am. Yeah, this looks like a trail. More of a well-used one. I don't know if it'll get any more altitude. Oh, we don't know what we're doing. Let's just do something. That trail looks interesting, but it's only wide for a short time before this drops back down into that higher valley. Go this way. I also don't want to be on the sun side. I have a relatively cool day. Above those rocks, it's probably where the snakes would sun. That peters out right past the trees. There's no real game trail going up on this ridge, and this is way too snaky. Unless you have boots for the prickly pear. It hides in there. Now I guess we're staying on this trail. The main one. For now. Or what is this? There should be some kind of cow trail into this section. No, I just can't bushwhack at this point. Stomped over here anyway. This gulch looks bizarre. Looks like the road goes down it and then up again. And then, I mean, what's on the other side of that ridge? It looks really intriguing. Does the road go up that way? I do not like this thick grass, but man, once you see a big giant rattlesnake, I mean, the size of a garden hose or bigger, sliding through this stuff, it kind of makes you wonder. It's like going back in the water. I've seen a few great whites. I think my stomping is working okay, though. And there's always something to see just a little bit further out. All right, well, fortune favors the bold. Losing some elevation, but it's better than just turning around and going back. All right, I'll keep stomping. We'll see what's on the other side of that ridge right there. I know, just another valley, but you never know. Another valley you've not seen. These choke cherries. Still have wild plums out here, but I think it frosted after they budded, so I don't see too much this year. Remember how many years ago this was a two-lane wagon track? Back down to mostly cattle trails, but it's all right. We're fairly clear. I wouldn't want it to happen, but depending on the situation, if you had to bring a lot of citizens in from cities, you could. There's so much room out here. No infrastructure. There is room. The bear went over the mountain, the bear went over the mountain. And see what we can see. Well, Oh, hey. I think I know exactly where I am. Yeah, that's Coal Creek Road. I came up here, I believe. On my last trip. There were some bulls over there, so I just turned around. All right, far out. Boy, that's quite a cutoff. That's really not that far. Creek is a good mile and a half, this one, before 10 mile, where I parked the car. That's a pretty good shortcut. I'm already pretty high up at elevation. You can tell by the way my hands are doing. So going that way, just over that rise, and then over the saddle, and then down, is a lot faster and shorter than walking down Coal Creek. You wouldn't have any, it'd be all downhill, but it'd be about five times as long. Right, which means I have the energy to go up a little further. This is about the last time I stopped because it was getting dark, and there were a couple bulls in the field. It didn't look like they liked me. A little bit more of an incline recently. These fantastic little hills. But it looks like we got another saddle pass or summit of sorts coming up. Well, I guess not really a summit or a saddle, just a little turn. Suppose I won't be satisfied until I get to the top of this. It's just been, the valley's closing up, getting a little bit tighter, and still going up on an incline. Didn't think we had that much incline here. More badlands rocks exposed up there. Okay, carry on. Oh, okay, I can't go up much farther. He said aloud. These are some giant slash piles. I think they're going to be 40 feet tall. I'm just going to light them up when snow comes. Not a free firewood, though. You can get up here. This is, Coal Creek's a pretty good road here. It's almost better than my access. Whew. All right, a little bit ways to go. There should be a top to this ridge or something somewhere. One day. Jeez Louise, what happened to the flat plains of eastern Montana? Okay, here we got the top of this ridge. What is that? Is that a slag pile? I haven't seen any sign of mining since I've been here. This part of Montana, except for coal mining. trail. It's just a good spot to get the rock. Well, I don't think there's any top peak per se. I'm just on the top of all these little tiny mesa type hills and mountains around with trees on them. It's a little vast area. All right, I gotta go all the way back, so it's probably the end of it for this day. Now that there's more badlands areas. Okay. Well, I could explore this area by just driving up Coal Creek more. Time to make it back. Beautiful day. A lot warmer than it thought to, and it's gonna get cloudy and cold, so good timing. But we could use some scale. This is the one I showed earlier, for the record, despite the sun glare. Like, I should get out of the glare. Un momento! I'm sure there'll be some glare anywhere. Anyway. I'm the king of the world! I saw that coming. I had the benefit of a forecast, but here's the rain that's coming in. It was only supposed to be a little brief break when it was sunny. About 5 degrees cooler at least. That was interesting going up there. Now it's just that white sign saying no motorized travel, take a right over those two ridges and then down to the car. Right, here we are back at that little summit. It's right, Coal Creek, at that far ridge, but it is beyond that one. I found these here. I'm outside the park now, so I can collect a rock if I want. Where did I find these? Is that where I found this specifically? I mean, it was within 5 yards of this place. They were like two or three of them. Little plates. I think that might make a little painting palette. Little canvas there. It's kind of neat.